So I just want to start by saying this is not a video on how to breed fancy or short-bodied goldfish, but more of a video exposing the world of fancy goldfish breeding and explaining what is going on behind the scenes. Because just over 2 years ago, when I first started getting into fish keeping, I didn't know any of this, and it might help shed some light on some controversy for people who are just getting into the hobby. I'm going to break this video up into 3 sections, and I'll have the timestamps down in the description below as well as the comments. And the 3 sections are going to be 1. How fancy goldfish are bred, 2. Health issues that fancy goldfish are prone to, and 3. My personal experience and opinion on keeping fancy goldfish. And if you guys do actually like this video, I would really appreciate it if you went down there and gave this video a like. That would help me out so much. And if you would like to see more videos by me in the future, make sure you go down there and hit that subscribe button and also hit that bell notifications button. I upload new fish videos every Friday. And let's go ahead and start on our first section, which is how fancy goldfish are bred. When I say fancy goldfish, I am referring to short-bodied, rounded goldfish, which are bred for their ornamental features. They are sometimes even referred to as ornamental goldfish. There are many types of fancy goldfish out there. There are Tamasaba, Bubble Eye Goldfish, Telescope, Veal Tail, Oranda, Lionhead, Ryukin, Celestial Eye, and Ranchu, just to name some of them. With a little help from our good old friend Google Scholar, I was able to come across an article which linked the origin of goldfish to the Chinese crushing carp. You can definitely see the resemblance of this fish in our modern day domesticated common goldfish. Goldfish were originally domesticated in China over 1,000 years ago. The gray fish, which was originally bred for food, would occasionally produce an orange, red, or gold-colored fish through a naturally occurring color mutation. This color mutation was selectively bred, and these fish were kept for ornamental purposes. Over millions of years of evolution, nature decided this was the best form for this species of fish for survival purposes. So how did we get from a fish naturally selected to look like this, to end up looking like this, to end up looking like this? When it comes to breeding just the regular common goldfish, I believe breeding the color mutation isn't really such a big deal since the internals of the fish have not changed. The only slight problem that I can think of is that these fish might have a bit less vigor from being bred in a smaller gene pool to achieve these desired colors. However, going from a common goldfish like this to a fancy goldfish like this comes with a lot of problems. I think most people are familiar with the pug dog breed, which funnily enough also originated in China. But that's not the only thing that pugs and fancy goldfish have in common. It's easy to see how cute these dogs are, but I'm sure many of you are aware of the controversy over breeding these dogs, as it is essentially breeding genetic disorders, which cause a slew of health problems in these dogs and lower their quality of life. Many people believe that breeding these dogs should be illegal, as well as the breeding of other short-snouted dogs, because it is cruel. And fancy goldfish actually originated in a similar fashion. Genetic mutations were selectively bred to achieve a desired aesthetic, which nature did not intend for, and for good reason. And this brings us to our second point, which is health problems that fancy goldfish are prone to. Look at this diagram of the organs of a common goldfish. Now compare them to the organs of a fancy goldfish. The organs of a fancy goldfish are compressed into a much tighter area, and these fish are prone to constipation, which can affect the swim bladder and can cause buoyancy problems. You may have even seen videos yourself of a fancy goldfish which is unable to swim straight, is floating or swimming on its side, or even upside down. This can also be caused by swim bladder disease, which these fish also seem to be prone to. Fancy goldfish, especially the telescope variety, are also known to have poorer eyesight than their long-bodied counterparts, and cannot swim as fast. And for this reason, many people say that you shouldn't keep fancy goldfish with long-bodied goldfish. Fancy goldfish also have a notably shorter lifespan than long-bodied goldfish. And apart from the challenges that fancy goldfish face in their lives, the breeding process is actually quite cruel itself. Fancy goldfish breeders look for specimens that possess the physical characteristics that adhere to some sort of arbitrary fancy goldfish standard. Fancy goldfish fry that do not meet this standard are often culled, aka murdered. And usually only a small percentage of fry are kept. And this brings me to our final section, which is my personal experience and opinion when it comes to keeping fancy goldfish. As I said earlier in this video, I've only been into keeping fish for close to 2.5 years, and it wasn't until more recently in my fish keeping journey that I learned about the origin of fancy goldfish. And to cut a long story short, I don't think I'm going to be buying any more fancy goldfish in the future, as I think it's unethical. Although, I do think that it is possible to keep fancy goldfish ethically by not actually buying them. I have a fan-tailed goldfish in my pool pond that I got from somebody on the Nextdoor app who is moving and trying to give the fish away to a good home. I think adopting fish this way is great and totally ethical. And same when it comes to pugs. I think they are such cute little dogs, but I would never buy one because I don't believe in breeding them. I would, however, adopt one from the animal shelter. Breeding fancy goldfish is essentially intentionally breeding genetic disabilities. And before I was aware of this, I did own a handful of fancy goldfish. When I first got my pool pond, I had 3 Oranda goldfish. Unfortunately, one of them passed away right after I got it due to some sort of swim bladder complication. I also had 2 Blackmoor goldfish at one point, which both passed away from ick soon after I got them. And just look at these ranchus. What kind of quality of life is that? In my opinion, it is a crime against nature to intentionally breed a fish like this. So that's my opinion on fancy goldfish, and I would love to know yours down in the comments below. Do you agree with me? Do you disagree? Feel free to let me know. And before I close out this video, I do have a few shoutouts. So I want to give a shout out to Joshua Santos. Thank you so much for your support and thank you for being an Aquamigo. I really appreciate it. Shout out to Mr. Goodbass. Thank you so much for being an Aquamigo and for your support. I have a shout out for Joel Shaw, aka AnimalTube. Thank you so much, Joel, for your support and for being an Aquamigo. I have a shout out for Vertigo117, aka Cedric. Thank you so much for your support and for being an Aquamigo. And I have a shout out for KM Aquatic Exotics. Thank you so much for being an Aquamigo and for your support. I appreciate all of you guys. If you yourself would like a shout out in one of my upcoming fish videos, all you have to do is go down to the comments below and comment I am an Aquamigo and I will shout you out in my next fish video. And once again guys, if you did actually like this video, I would really appreciate it if you went down there and gave this video a like. That would help me out so much. And if you would like to see more videos by me in the future, make sure you go down there and hit that subscribe button and also hit that bell notifications button. I post new fish videos every Friday. If you would like to follow me on Instagram, my handle is @YT_Tobias. I post there pretty much daily, so if you want to follow me there, that would be great, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Peace!